Is there, have you thought about possibilities of just increasing people's aesthetic experience of the world? I mean, in principle, if we can only see a tiny sliver of the electromagnetic spectrum, if you could open up a much bigger spectrum. We were asked yesterday to imagine a color that you hadn't seen before. That's a really hard thing to do.
Oh, impossible, right.
But what if you could let people give people these extra senses? Do you think that at some point new qualia would open up and suddenly the world that we see now, you would just see a million more colors and you would just be full of joy?
Yeah, so I think so. One of the ways to get at this question is, for example, we know that some fraction of females have not just three types, but four types of color photoreceptors in their eyes. So they're seeing colors that the rest of us can't see. You know, they can discriminate colors, say, oh, that's different from that, but to us, it would look exactly the same. Okay. What's interesting is that they can't explain to you what they're seeing that's different because you've never experienced those other colors, and so you're stuck in your Umwelt, you know, the experience of the world that you have. In the same way that if you talk to someone who's colorblind, you can't explain what purpleness is or red or something like that. But the difficulty is getting you outside of your fence line of what you're able to perceive, right? You can see a certain number of colors and that's it. You can't see more than that. So I've been very interested in this question of how does the brain build qualia and how do you build new qualia? So my hypothesis is, remember where we started about how it's all just spikes. My hypothesis, it's about the structure of the data coming in. So your two retinas are, you know, two-dimensional sheets where you've got spikes coming through. Your eardrums are picking up on a one-dimensional signal of pressure changes. You know, your nose is picking up on mixtures of molecules, things like that. Okay, I think the structure of the data somehow determines the qualia, because you would never confuse sight with sound. If I showed you something, you wouldn't say, oh, I just heard something. Even though it's all spikes in there. So I think it has to do with the structure. The reason I'm bringing this up is because as we feed new data in, we might be able to actually build new qualia, where you have a new sense that's not hearing or touch or sight or smell, but it's another thing. And what I think this means really quickly, I think what this means is this could sort of be like a speciation event for the human species where we start having very different experiences. Now, I just want to emphasize this is a different degree of the same thing in the sense that we're already all having different experiences about things. But it may be that I can experience something that you can't.
Right, right.